What's up? Come join me for lunch. Get my tater chips out of the way. Join me for lunch, man. Come on, what's up? Where you at? What are you having for lunch today? Leftovers? Some Subway, some fast food? Well, today, we're going to wait till 12:05 again. In the meantime, we're just going to jam the Robin Thicke. I wish I could dance, man. If I could dance, oh snap, I'd be dancing everywhere I go. The library, grocery store, everywhere. Who's joining us today? If you join us, please share. Lunch with Mat, once again. Lunch with Mat, lunch with Mat, lunch with Mat. Let me stop. Lunch with Mat. If you're on, say what's up. Don't be shy. Let me know you're here. And then share it with someone. Share it with a friend or someone that's not a friend. Just share. But say what's up. Don't come on here and have lunch with Mat and not say what's up. I want to say hello. I want to say hello to whoever's out there. And we have a good talk today. Last time I felt rushed because there was so much going on. I had just finished seeing a client, and I had to prepare for a meeting. And so this time, I'm gonna take my time today. Please share. Waiting on you to share. We're gonna start at 12:05. And if you're there, just say what's up. Say what's up, Mat. How you doing, Mat? What's up? It's gonna be a real topic today with Mat. Lunch talks. Come join the convo. Excuse me. All right, so I'm waiting on a couple, maybe one or two individuals that will join. And if you are already on, invite a friend, you know? Ask them to come have lunch with us. This is lunch with Mat, so I want to have lunch with you guys. I want to have conversations with you guys about different topics. Is that my boy Trey I just saw jump on? Oh, man. What's good? If you're there, just say what's up. I'd like to hear from you guys. Just throw me a deuce or something because I'm here for you guys. Man, I'm here for the people. So if you're on, share, tell a friend. We're about to get started in 1 minute. We're gonna have this real cool conversation. What they do? Blessings. Blessings, young man. Blessings, King. It's been a minute, man. You gotta come through the office too, man. Mi casa su casa. You already know. Alright? So I'm gonna wait for that, man. I'm gonna lay around for it, like I used to say in the old school. I'm gonna lay around for it. Alright, one more minute and then we'll get this conversation going. James, what's good? How you doing? Damali. Hey, you just celebrated a birthday. Somebody just celebrated a birthday, so happy belated, Damali. Hope you had a wonderful birthday. And if you're on already, just say what's up. I'd love to hear from you guys, you know? So the convo is getting started right now. I got Robin Thicke in the background playing. I can't dance, man. But if I could, yo, if I could dance, man, I'd be a fool. But I'm not one of those dudes. I just two-step. Keep it in there, keep it in there, keep it in there, in the pocket. Two steps. That's it. All right, let's get this convo going. So, topic for the day is that sex talk. That sex talk, man. I want to know from you guys. Did you guys have the sex talk growing up? Because it's a problem. It is a problem. Not having the sex talk, that is. I'm going to tell you how my sex talk went in a minute. But I want to know from you guys, have you had this? Did you guys have the sex talk growing up with your parents, your mom, your dad, auntie, uncle, that awkward 5 minutes or 10 minutes, however long it took for them to tell you about what they call the birds and the bees or something else? Did you guys have that talk with your parents? That's what we're talking about today. That's what we're talking about today with Lunch Talk. So if you did, just say, yes, I did. And if you didn't, say, no, I didn't. And then was it awkward? Was it awkward? It was too late, Trey. Yo, was it awkward, though, to have that talk with your parents or your mom, your dad? What did they say? How did they break the ice? It's like, hey, son, we're going to have that talk today. We're going to talk about sex. So that's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about the talk that should have happened earlier, Trey, but didn't happen. So no formal talks with the folks. Someone said, oh, man, you know, this is a recurring thing that I'm running into. No talks. So then the follow-up question to that would be, if our parents didn't have that talk with us, how do we then have that conversation with our kids? How do we bridge that gap? How do we change that, you know? Man, so mom talked. Mom talked about sex, gross visuals. Oh, man, no, keep it away. No. So let me tell you how my sex talk went. It was too late for me too, man. It was way too late. You know, I have Haitian parents. Someone just said that too. Haitian parents don't talk to their kids about sex. And that's a shame. That's a part of the problem right there. Why not? Haitians, you know what? Haitians act like they don't have sex, man. But I know if you're a Haitian child, you walked in on your parents at least a couple times. Sad visual, really bad visual, but they act like they don't have sex, you know? And so this is something that's important for us to talk about. So let me tell you about my sex talk with my parents. I'm of Haitian descent, and I was about 16 at the time. And my dad's not watching because he don't have Facebook, so I'm gonna just get this out the way. My siblings might watch, and they better not snitch, because I'm gonna find you. Anyway, so this is what my dad said. He pulled me aside as a 16-year-old kid. He said, listen, son. He said, if you are having sex, or if you have sex and you get a girl pregnant, I got your back. And that was the extent of the sex talk. He said, if you get a girl pregnant, I got your back. That was it. So basically, he just gave me license. He's, get out there. Go do what you do. If you come home and someone said they're pregnant by you, I'm going to deny. And that was the extent of the talk. Here's the problem with that right there. Here's the problem with that. That's not education. No parts of that is educating me about sex or the do's and don'ts of sex. And so I learned through trial and error, through magazines, through videos, through pornography. That's how I learned about sex. And that wasn't good at all. But here's the other danger of not having the conversation about sex in the Black community. When we don't have a comfortable space to talk about sex, the positive and negative parts of it, what we create is an atmosphere where those who are being abused sexually don't feel comfortable enough to come out and talk about it. Last month, which was October, was, I think, Domestic Violence Awareness Month. And I was having this conversation at a panel discussion, and they were saying that a lot of them have been sexually abused, but it happened in a previous generation. And so what this tells me is that if the previous generation isn't comfortable enough to talk about sex, and we don't create an environment where our kids are comfortable enough to talk about sex, so if something happens to them sexually, they won't feel comfortable talking to us. So as a therapist, I would like to know how we can change that. What will make you more comfortable to talk about sex? Is it education? Is it the timing? is it? Well, I mean, what is it? Do you need a safer space? Because we got to change that, man. There is a lot of young women and young men that were sexually abused as children, but they never said anything because their family, their environment they grew up in wasn't a safe place to talk about sex. I tell you, listen, we spiritualize it, we demonize it, we villainize it, and that's not cool. Sex is a beautiful thing, man. Sex is real. All right, let me not go. That's maybe for another talk. But listen, we have to find a way to start having these conversations with the next generation. Are we setting them up for failure? You know, like all of the mistakes I made. Oh my gosh, man. Mistake after mistake after mistake after mistake. As far as not knowing what the purpose of sex was, how to actually please not just myself but my partner, thinking that sex was mainly about what's in it for me. And then the other parts of that is that if we're not educated about it, then as males, that is, if we're not educated about it, then how are we then supposed to enter into a relationship having expectations of women that aren't educated about it? So a question was out there. What about sex before marriage? Great question. I'm not the jury. The jury's not out on that. Like, I can't say yes or no for anyone's personal or spiritual belief. Now, for me personally, I did have sex before marriage. Was it all that it was wrapped up to be? No. You know, frankly, I wish I would have waited, because having sex before marriage did more damage to my relationship than it did good in my relationship. What do I mean? It means the expectations are all wrong now. It means that the education that I thought I had about sex that I came into the relationship with tainted the expectations that I should have. It means that, I don't know, I just, you know, once you actually get in the place where sex isn't just about the physical, but it's about the spiritual, it's about the emotional, it's about the social, it's about the, you know, all of those different aspects of sex, then you can see that you were wasting your time before. You never really connected intimately with other people if you never really had all those levels of intimacy, you know, not just physical. Physical is good, but there's emotional, there's spiritual, there's social, there's relational. All these different areas where you can connect, never really had that. It was just about physical. Wham, bam, right? That was it. And what it does in your current relationship, it taints it, man. You know, I sincerely wish that I would have waited. I wish that I would have had a good sex talk, educating me about the highs and lows of sex, the beauty of sex, the romance of it, you know, all the levels of intimacy that comes with sex. And so I want to talk more. I want to hear more from you guys. What are your thoughts about this topic, the sex talk? You know, we heard Haitian parents don't talk about sex. We got to change that. It's not just Haitian parents. I think West Indians, Black Americans too, you know, I don't know about the other side. So what are some of your thoughts? I see, what else is out there? Mine was just don't get pregnant. Oh man, you know, I mean, don't get pregnant. How you gonna do that? They talk about condoms, you know? I don't even think my dad know what a condom is. You know what I'm saying? That's sad, but man, somebody said they disagree with something. I disagree with waiting. I disagree with waiting. Gotta try to feel. Well, like I said, you know, each person is on. You gotta see what's out there for you. But I'll tell you this though. Trying out the feel, right? Let's say you do try the feel and you connect with somebody so good physically. I mean, that sex is like right, but you don't connect on all those other levels. Then what? Then what? Then what? Yes, the sex is great. You got to drive the whip, right? Take it around the block to see if it's good. But then what? You know, sex isn't just physical. And you realize that in marriage, it's different because there's way more levels to connect intimately, you know? And then sex, when you do connect on those other levels, man, it's out there, you know? It's not just physical. You know, I don't know if anybody had this experience. I like to keep it real, but have you ever had sex with a person and then sex was over and you're like, oh, dang. So What now? Because you don't have nothing else that connects you? Like, there's nothing there? Nothing? Nothing at all? That's what it's like when you don't connect on those levels, you know? When you connect on that spiritual, that emotional, that intellectual, that social, that relational, it's on a whole nother level, you know? And so that's why it's important. Yes, yeah, I get it. I get it, you know? However, if it's your first time driving, you're going to love that car regardless. It doesn't matter what car, it doesn't matter how the car drives. If it's your first time driving, you're going to love it. So the test driving theory, you know, that's one way to look at it. All right, let's see what else other people are saying. I have had 13-year-old talk. I have a 13-year-old. I got a 13? Man, you better have that talk by 7. Come on, by even earlier, man. You gotta have the talk, you know. And if you don't know how to have that talk, holla at me, inbox me. I mean, there are plenty of resources out there. There are books, there are, you know, educational videos, but you gotta have that talk, man. 13, you know, we were wilding at 13, man. You know, so 13, man, that's kind of late. We gotta have that talk earlier. So teenagers not thinking about connection on these levels. I get it. Teenagers aren't thinking about that connection, and that's our fault. Because we're not educating them enough to know the importance of what it means to connect on those levels. And then they make the same mistakes we do or we've done, you know, they make the same mistakes. And then when they fail to have something that's substantial on that level, something that's not really lasting long, something that's just really superficial, and they think they're putting it all in it, then they get crushed. And you have people that are wounded or have, excuse me, I drank some ginger ale, got me gassy. But you have people that are wounded or that are walking around trying to connect on these levels based on other issues that they had that don't really know how to connect. And it's causing more issues, causing more friction, causing more babies being born out of wedlock, causing more baby mama, baby daddy, all this stuff like that, because they're not educated. You know, yes, they're not thinking about it, but how do we get them to think about it? What do we have to do now that we know better? Or at least learning more to know better. What can we do now to change that conversation, to change that narrative? Because listen, it's going to be on us. If we fail, like other generations have failed, then it's going to be on us. We had all the excuses that our parents didn't have the talks, but what's going to be our excuse? You know, we got to tighten up. All right. So what else we got out there? I got to go in the, all right, AB, I see you, man. All right. We have to have experiences in order to understand connection, and the experience comes from real life trial and error, not books and theories. I got you, man. Yeah, you're right. You have to have experience. I like that, right? But why can't you have that experience with that one person? Why do you have to have it with multiples, you know? And because what you're doing is that all you're doing is having a body trail, you know? And it's like, you think what you're doing is preparing yourself for something. What you're doing is removing yourself from that connection that you could have based on all of those trials and errors and stuff like that. Yeah, so if I walk in the dark and I bump my toe, and I tell you, hey, don't walk in the dark or you bump your toe. Are you still going to walk in the dark just to bump your toe? You know, the trial and error thing is like, yeah, I have to make the mistakes myself. I get it. But come on, man. We got to do better. You know, what else is out there? Let's see. Somebody said, had the sex talk with my son when he turned 13. He was way more responsible than me at that age. Yeah, hey, the difference it will make when we have that sex talk with our kids, man, you know? And, you know, I have 4 daughters. They're 4 and 5. And listen, the sex talk is different for different age groups. You don't have to necessarily go into details at that early age, but you can start getting them to understand their bodies and getting them to understand what intimacy is, what levels of intimacy is, because we share intimate moments with our kids. And so let them know this is what it is. And by that, you get them to understand the other aspects of intimacy rather than just the physical, you know? And so we have to have these conversations, man. You know, like I said, if you don't know, there are plenty of resources that are out there. Inbox me. Holla at your boy. Well, not your boy. I'm a grown man now. So holla at me And then I'll see what resources I can have made available for you guys. Also, there is a young lady. She was just on social media. I'm going to post her information up there. She wrote a book. Doctor, I can't remember her name. I'm sorry. She's going to be mad at me. But she wrote a book on having that specific talk with your kids, you know? Somebody else wrote, what are your thoughts on the lack of focus on the silence? What are your thoughts on the lack of focus on silent teachers of sex, music, TV, internet? Man, you know, we don't talk about the effects of media. Well, I spoke about that earlier. I spoke about that. I didn't have the talk with my parents, and I learned through other resources. I learned through television and stuff like that. And it's like, so if they learn outside of the home, what do we expect? You know, do you think the media, do you think the gatekeepers of entertainment cares about your household? Really? Please, man, they don't care about us. They don't care nothing about us. And they will educate you all the wrong ways. They will send all the wrong messages to you and your family about sex, about everything that's out there, and you will know that you will not be the wiser, you know? So it's our job to educate ourselves for our community, for our future, and do something different about it. If we don't, then, I mean, then we're just as guilty. You know, we have to do something different. We got to do something different, you know? Like, having these conversations. So now that we could come back to this topic again, because I see this is more of a topic that pushes buttons, but we got to have that talk. We can't feel awkward about it. We have to look it right in the face and, hey, listen, let's talk about it. You know, let's talk about it. First of all, make sure you're comfortable enough to talk about it. I'm reviewing it and I'm exiting. Make sure you're comfortable enough to talk about it, because when you are, you create an environment where if something goes left in a child's life, then they will feel comfortable enough to talk to you about it, because the space, the environment, the atmosphere that you set is a comfortable environment where sex isn't taboo, where sex isn't villainized, and they can talk about their highs and lows and if they have had experiences with it. And you want that. You need that to happen, especially this day and age, because a lot of exposure, you know, a lot of exposures are out there, and you want to know everything, man. You got to be open to these conversations, open to these talks. Listen, my battery's on 10%. I did not charge before I came on here, so I don't want this thing to go out without me saying thanks for joining Matt. Thanks for joining me for Lunch Talks. I appreciate it. Next week, we'll have another conversation on Monday and Wednesdays, other conversations on Mondays and Wednesdays. If you have a topic that you want me to discuss, let me know, inbox me, or send me a text message for those who have my number. If you don't have my number, well, I don't know. You can still inbox me, all right? Have a great day. Enjoy your lunch. And don't eat too much. Peace.